thanks for being here. It seems that we're streaming live, so all my mistakes will be recorded, and yours too if you are here, standing here. So there's a few things we have to discuss, but first I want to say that yesterday I had a nice board meeting, and we went over all the teams, how they were doing. Some of them are not as visible as we want, but most of them are. So it seems that we're heading towards an excellent event. So thank you all. Applaus voor jezelf.nl. this is really awkward. Can I have a mic to hold? Can I? No space for my laptop. Where we are at now from projectleiding, we are working. We have worked our asses off with a team of 8 people to bring to create a permit, and I wanted to show a little bit about the permit, and I want to show something else too. Last week, as you've all seen. We released a number of ticket sales for once. First time that happened. We came with this graph. For some reason, there was no event from the Dutch hacker scene where these numbers were published. I don't know why, but we thought, since we do everything transparent, let's release this too. This is where we are at now, and or a few days ago. And if you look, there's some magic happening. Can I walk around with this thing? Oh yeah, and the camera is also moving. So what you see happening here is a beautiful spike. This blue and green line are the Ohm ticket sales, and this is when one of two things happened: or it was the program being announced, or it was Fox IT drama. The first one, the program, is being worked on, because that's really important to have a lot of good speakers. There's a half NARP out there with a list of speakers that have been confirmed that we really want there. So the program is looking excellent. And I hope that there will be a sooner release of a preliminary program. So that leaves us with drama. In order to get an increase in ticket sales, we need some drama. And therefore, I see some volunteers. We were thinking of starting the Drama Operation Center, or the DOC. Please, if you have plans for excellent drama, so we can sell more tickets, that would be great. I see people walking out. Okay. this is going to be terrible. I have got a slightly newer graph now, made this morning. Fresh cyber. And there you see that what exactly as predicted. You see that the Ohm line is slowly creeping up. And there's one thing that we really need. If you compare this to Ohm, we are doing a lot of things different now. And one of the main complaints was not decent angel catering that we have now working on, and showers missing during teardown. Yes, we have them. They're already there, and they will stay there. So I think, in organizational sense, we're doing fine. But because of that experience was a bit harsh for some, they say, "Well, I'm not going to SHA because Ohm sucked." And we are working really hard to make this event right, make this the best hacker camp we've ever made. So you know, if you can help with getting more people to the event, that would be the best thing that could happen for the event. because we're doing fine in organizational sense, but for ticket sales, we still need a lot. There's still a lot of tickets to go, like 1,000, 1,500 stuff. So please, please do that. If you can, where you can, invite your friends, colleagues, tell, tweet, use whatever method you can, except extortion and all the other stuff. Oh, I heard that extortion is like drama, so then... So, no, that's where we are at now. How are we now? We are at over half of the sales we need. Largely over the half of the sales we need. We found some nice sponsors for the badge, so that saves also a lot of money. But still, we do need about a ticket or 1,000 or 1,500 to be sold. So that's that. And now let's go to the permit, because we've worked our asses off for getting this permit done. And here's a beautiful folder that shows a lot of stuff for this permit. So let's go over it quickly. The project leading is working on a draaiboek. You know that there's a planning spreadsheet somewhere. Please make sure that your team has updated that for their team. But this has the phase. Oh, that doesn't work well. But phasing of the event and when happens what, and this will be expanded with all the details. So the dependency plan is also correct, and it will be a terrible long list. So it's more of the same. We expect that we have a meeting every morning, and also that every team has their own meeting to see what's up, what they can expect, and what's happening. And we've planned that early in the morning, because hackers wake up early in the morning. There's no problem with that at all at a hacker camp. And there's a lot of suppliers, of course. What we also do is we have a team that we have several teams. Oh, this is worth. This is going to be fun. So there are, during the event, there are a few teams that do safety and security. I don't know what this is. And blah blah blah, crafts. I think this is the most important list. So there's a safety organization during the event, not only mandated, but also very practical. There will be a team that is up 24/7 in three shifts over days, and they will help out with managing the event, managing the foods and food trucks, handle all the safety issues, handling first aid and general security. And they all have nice phone numbers. These are the phone numbers. They will, of course, be shared. But during the event, you can just call 112 if there's really an emergency on your deck, and you will get in touch with the Centrale Postveiligheid. There's a group of people that will do that, manage all incidents. And this team is 15 people. And they will do shifts of 12 hours, and they are allowed to sleep during the 12 hours, but have their phone on the loudest settings. But that is pretty serious, and we started like 2 days before the event and ended at 1 or 2 days after the event. It's 9 days in total. So there's such a team. All the positions are there. You probably know most of them, only probably not the people from safety and first aid. From safety, those are from scouting. First aid are from both our organization, I think the Red Cross. So that's the event team. The program, this is something we did. This is like the nice drawing where everything Well, that's the map, but only in a more fancier grid layout, thanks to Rutkola. And we have a lot of temporary constructions, such as tents, tents and stuff. So you can see that all the tents are there, and that there's somebody. SA007 is building a large clock, 9 meter high clock, with fluorescent bulbs. That's TL. That's also has also to be there. And of all these things, we have to make a drawing. So this is track 1 and 2, and Red Lizard drew every of those chairs, all those pink things. It was fun, right? So we have a floor plan for every of the tents. This is track 3, and you see the bar, and it goes on and on and on and on and on and on and on, and there's more. So you can imagine that we worked our asses off to get this done. There will be a nice tower for radio communication. And there's a project for flamethrowers by Dimi. And then there's another thing, the tents, how they look, what they do, how they are calculated to withstand a certain amount of wind, how they handle fire also, what kind of constructions we have, like towers and an entrance gate. Oh, those are a bit small, but... another broadcast tower and this clock. This is the drawing. So with these things, the municipality is obviously asking questions on how can this be safe. And luckily, Bas knows what he's doing. And he also included a lot of calculations on how this works. I hope the municipality would understand. I have a hard time. What we've also done, there's safety sector. So the safety team is doing is planning the site into several sectors, so they can communicate with each other about that. This is a map that I cannot comprehend yet. Oh, this is where the fire extinguishers are. So these new, these beautiful blue dots are fire extinguishers, and there are a lot of fire extinguishers. Here, every year, here. Of course, there's a code of conduct, and we have to hand it in Dutch, so we have to translate that to Dutch. This is what we have to do with evacuations. So you see these nice green arrows that we used main road and go to the parking lot C1 in the front of the event. But those details will be shared, of course, at the event with a nice explanation of how that works. There's one exit, and that's this main exit, C1, that has the biggest capacity for people. Of course, a set of house rules. For example, don't panic and be excellent to each other. I think those are the most important, and it says a thing about the environment and vehicles, sound, waste, lost and found, photography, drugs, alcohol, smoking, fire, etc., etc., etc. So it's a lot of stuff. And usually we don't have to have these, but they are requested, so we took them from all the other events and made a selection of what we think fits best of our event. Some other management stuff. How security works. This is a book of how security works. That's by the security team. This is a book of how first aid works. That's for the first aid team. And there are some scenarios what happens when there's a fire, what happens when there's X, Y, or Z, then it's also described here. There's a traffic plan, and this is also very nice that, let's see. So there's this NARS parking field with a ridiculous amount of plated material. And you see that we're going to make a one-way route of the event. So you can only do this circle. Even more and more and more. And where all the traffic signs are going to be, they're going to be placed. That's also a lot of work because you have to do that correct. And we did that nearly correct, only we had the first sign reversed. So it was wrong and we had to do it again. So all the signs that we have to rent. We are allowed to advertise the name of the event, so you will see SHA 2017 with an arrow. We'll be very clear. These are pictures of the emergency roads on the site. They have a nice red sign with C1, 2, and 3. And we made these because we wanted to be sure that these are correct. There was some mix-up somewhere, and we fixed that. How the traffic signs work, how parking works with traffic attendants and such, and the bridge and when it opens and such. It's a lot. And how the bar works. I hope this is the new version. So when the bar is open, all the bars are open from 2 to 2. And they all serve alcohol, and or a low amount of alcohol. And the main bar at the center of the site is open 24/7. And how we work with food and music and all that stuff. But there's a lot of people that have been that took a training, sociale hygiene in the horeca. SHV or SVH? I always mix it. SVH. And you have to answer questions like, what do you have to do when somebody is drunk in your bar? And how can you summon someone to leave, et cetera, et cetera? And that has been a walk in the park. Like 8 people have it now or something. Currently 5. I already see 3 here. 4. Yeah. So we are allowed to sell you alcohol too. Hooray. And of course the request in itself, which is also a long formal document with lots of questions. What are we going to do? When is it going to happen? Do we have stages? Do we use a security company? Yes or no? Why not? Do we have merchandise? What can they expect from sound and audio? How do we do promotion, etc., etc.? So, and I don't know this one by the top of my head. This is also a safety plan. And Jeroen? Do the safety then. There's another safety plan with everything in it. I think this is this is the city council. Okay, this is a form from the city council that we have to fill out in their format. And you see that all the previous events are mentioned and etc. And how many people we expect on the site before and after. Yeah, and this is also, it goes on and on and on and on. So you see, there's been a lot of effort, like insane amount of work that went into the permit. And if you think you're bored out now because of this list, well, we are even more bored out. We had to write that stuff. So But it is good, and it's good to know what we have to do if something goes wrong. That's very nice to know. And it's good to have certifications, and it is good to have plans. So this is looking like a really steady event. And next week, we're going to have a meeting with the city council, and they will obviously find some things where they say, oh, this has to be different, this has to be different. We hope that's not too much and that it's easily to fix, but that's something for them. So that's the permit part. That was a lot of work. I think we can go to a somewhat lighter material. What shall we do? What we can do is now a few updates by teams, what their status is, what they need. Please share your updates, and I will start with some funny things right now. So please prepare your stuff if you need that at all. Oh, my lack of cyber was destroyed, I see. So, one moment. I forgot one thing. Are there any questions about the permit? No? Good. So for decoration, we have bought some things and we're working on some things. Polyfloyd, do you have some other things to add if you can come forward already? Do you have anything to add? Like the list of projects or something like that? Go, come on, you can do it. So this is the lack of cyber. And what it does is basically have a nice shiny light, and they will be on the main road on the left and the right of the road, and there will be like 20 or 40 of them, and especially when it's dark it looks really cool.
Okay, so it's important to have crocodiles on your event. So we bought about 80 of these crocodiles. And more of all, we're planning on having signs, a gate, some flags. And we've planned a date on the 17th of June, in 2 weeks, to collectively make these flags and signs and the gate. I'd like to invite you all to come help us on this day. We start at 10 in the morning. Now, if you're not able to survive this, survive waking up this early, you're welcome to join us somewhere in the afternoon.
Where?
At Hack 42.
We also have this nice thingy laying around here. This beautiful pink lightsaber. There are different colors, but I thought pink was the best one to have on camera because white balancing issues. We bought, there's a truck outside with 100 of these things. And we're going to give them nice colors and make sure that the field is properly illuminated. All the Electra facility boxes will have a few of these around, and some tents will get some to get a nice atmospheric light. If you want to look at all the projects that there are, damn it. There is a map of this. And this is the map. Again. And you can read exactly nothing of this map. So here we have an entrance gate. And that small rope over here are the lights that illuminate the trees. We're working on getting 3 kilometers of these lights that you can remote control and give the color you want. That's not going to be exploited by anyone at a hacker conference. there will be some sharks. There will be a monument for Gititelaar on the island. Well, yeah, we just showed the cube lamps. There will be all kinds of LED lights, UV lights. There will be a sign for SHA that is worked on. And there's more. This is all on the deco page. So I would like to invite someone else to say something about their team. Perhaps June for the. I'm wearing something.
This is my lovely assistant, Elger. He's showing the official shirt. This is the first sample that I got yesterday of the shirt that we're selling, or we have sold. And Elger will now show the hoodie as well. So this is all the embroidered logo. These are the samples. We're still going to work on the coloring a bit because the letters, they fall away with the gray background. Yeah, there's Sha on the hoodie there. The colors of the event are on the, how do you call these?
Anklets,
yeah.
Sorry?
This is a life jacket. This is the first sample, and we can make comments on this one before we do the production run. Life jacket.
No, it's not a life jacket.
It's not a life jacket.
We'll throw you in the water and see what happens.
There's the neck tape, and of course the cyber logo for the sizing. Yeah. And then we have the back, the cryptographic hash function world tour with all the encryption protocols and what's broken and not. And of course, these are the men versions. Maybe you can show the female sizes as well.
Fits perfectly.
Yeah. This is the female large.
Also
with the same. And of course the nice female hoodie. With the zip cord in the colors. The SHA logo on the right arm, the patches. They're on all the shirts as well. And there should be, no, that's not here, is it? Yeah, there's more color down here. So, yeah, that's it. What's the name of the? It's a robot shruggy.
Name. Doesn't have a name.
Doesn't have a name yet. Maybe we can make a competition out of that. Who wants to name it? Shruggy.
Shruggy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do we have a life jacket?
No, we don't have a life jacket. I would bring your own life jacket. But I'm sure that when you get into the water, there's lots of gallant gentlemen that come and save you.
Anyone else? come forward. More teams, more things to show. There's a lot happening. Everybody, there's enough time, so thanks.
Wow. Hi, we're from Team Badge, and here it is. At least that's the final proto. It works, and we're ordering parts by the thousands, and lanyards and bags and stickers and pieces of Velcro. It's amazing what you can get from China in volume. It's also the nicest experience to know that tenths of a cent matter in these businesses. So changing a display saves 10,000 euros. Negotiating a bit more about one LED saves 400 or 500 euros. It's staggering the amount of money we're spending on the batch. So the hardware is complete. It's entering production in mid-June. So when we're receiving the limited edition ESP32s, we're getting a special version of the ESP32 module just for us. So that's nice. The e-ink display is already in the country, so they're nearly here, and it's going to be awesome. On the software side, nearly all the driver work is done. We're working now on getting MicroPython to run and our data distribution network up and running, and then we should be good to go. Let me see what was else. We are going to do a batch kit assembly weekend somewhere early July, where we need some hands to put together all the batch kits. So the badge, the display, the battery, the lanyard, the stickers, etc. Put them all in a bag so they can be handed out at the start of the event. At the moment, everyone who is buying a ticket will still get a badge. So if you don't have a ticket, I'm looking at you people on the stream, get your ticket now. You can still get a badge and still be part of this awesome awesome experience. The CTF team is looking into writing a CTF app just for the badge, or a challenge for the badge. And this week we also launched a crowdfunding campaign with stretch goals. We want to provide you with additional nice little parts like LEDs, a vibration motor, etc. It's all on our wiki page, it's on the blog. If you want to donate to the badge so we can buy more parts for your kit, please do so. And if you want to help out with software, please be in touch. We're having a few more protos, and you can join in. Yes? I'll repeat the question. The function of the badge primarily is to be the first and foremost the name tag that you can actually read, that you can actually change. So the name tag is foremost. After that, we're looking at the fire plan, the schedule for the conference, so you know how to get around the conference, where everything is happening. And from that point on, it's probably going to be whatever people will write, it will do. So it's going to be a very expensive hacking experience. Yeah? When we know, you will know. We're nowhere near that stage yet. But it's at some point we need to get some information from you guys how to hook everything together. But that's going to be later on. Yeah. That depends on how often you use it. Sorry, I'll repeat the question. The expected battery life and power usage. Well, we're hoping for a day. It's a 1 amp hour, am I saying it right?
Yeah, 1 amp hour.
1 amp hour battery. And if you, the nice thing is it's an e-ink display. So if you put something on the screen, it can just stay there and the screen can go to sleep. The ESP can go to sleep. It saves a lot of power. So if you use your badge and your software wisely, you should last long enough. Another. You need to talk to Benatsky on that. Sorry, the question was, can it be solar powered? Talk to the alt power guy.
You said you had your own version of the ESP. Is that including the new backdoor?
I expect that within. Oh, sorry. No, he talked to a microphone. Everyone could hear him.
Here is the microphone.
Okay. I expect that within the hour of opening the event, the batch will be so completely hacked that we'll need to redo all of the software. That's my estimate.
So that's one challenge.
That's at least one of the challenges, yeah. And then we'll have to find him and kick him, and then we can go on with the conference.
Sorry?
Okay. So that's it from Badge, I think. It's going to be awesome, and we would like you to help us if you can, financially or with time in developing. Thank you.
Please step up. Step up. Step up. Then I'm going to fix my laptop because of video awesomeness.
I don't need the laptop, so. Let me see. Well, I'm Rolf. I work for the bar, food court, and lounge team. All those teams are actually going pretty well. For the bar, we're currently ordering everything that we want to drink. Some people got their certification, so we can actually sell alcohol, which is great. So that works actually pretty well. For the food court, we're in contact now with someone, with an external party that organizes most of the food court. That means that they recommend good food trucks to us. We contract them, and they help us with organizing all the practical stuff, such as regulation compliant cooling on site and all the other things that we didn't think about. So that will be great. I receive quite a lot of suggestions for food trucks. Feel free to send them to me and we'll discuss them, but there's absolutely no promise that we'll actually contract them, because we have a limited space for food trucks, because there's only so much money people will spend on food, and if we add more food trucks, then a single food truck will get less revenue, and the less revenue they get, the less interesting for them it becomes to be at our event. So there is a trade-off in that. DJ Spock's working quite hard on the lounge. He is mainly focusing on the loud lounge. Can we get the map on the screen? There is a loud lounge and a silent lounge. The loud lounge is over there. That will be where the party is, where music is and everything. And there is also a silent lounge, which is over there in the harbor. For the silent lounge, we still need hands. So, you like to do that? Okay.
Doing that. Fixed.
You're working on it. Cool. We need to talk. the last team that I'm responsible for is the Family Village, which is actually not going very, very well. We worked on it. There are a lot of ideas, but we need hands to execute them. I picked sort of randomly a set of dates for meetings and invited everyone who... there are some people who are somewhat connected to the Family Village and said they want to do something. So we're trying to get those people together and make it awesome. But there's still a lot of things to do. So if you do not have already enough work on your plate, feel welcome to join. Check the Team Family Village page on the wiki for the dates of the meetings and show up. There's a lot of things to do. So and also a lot of small tasks, so if you do not have much time but can do some things, then just show up and pick up some tasks. I think that's it.
Questions?
Oh, yes.
I have a question, because
I'm from Team Content.
Yep.
And we have a lot of submissions for workshops for kids and those things.
I know.
We're trying to get in touch with you guys, but so didn't manage.
Yeah, that hasn't been very successful to get in touch with us.
Yeah.
No, it's true. It's on the to-do list to assign someone who will get in touch with you to get through those submissions and get into FRAP and work with you on that.
Yes, thank you.
So it is on our list.
Yeah, it would be very nice to be quick. Like if you have someone just to get into FRAP, have a conversation, what's going to be hosted by the family village.
Okay, cool. Other questions? No questions? Cool.
Anybody else?
Oh, hi.
Please don't fight over the microphone.
Okay. Hello, I'm here from Team Build Up and Teardown. There has been some unfortunate development recently, which is that as of about 2 weeks ago, we lack a Teardown coordinator, and we need one. The Teardown coordinator is the person who makes sure that after the event, everything is cleaned up and removed from the terrain afterwards, who manages the large to-do list of everything that needs to be done in this regard, keeps track of the dependency chain, and makes sure that everything actually happens. And who is also the person who is not going to leave the terrain until it's done. And at the moment, we don't really have one, which means that if no one signs up for this, then I will have to do it, and everything will go to shit, because I already do the build-up, and experience teaches us that after someone has done this for the build-up, they are no longer in the best state to do a good job of doing the same thing for the teardown, because of exhaustion and all that sort of thing. So, sign up. Thanks. Questions? Oh, I'm so good at that. Okay, anyone else? Sorry?
No, because this is a drama afterwards. We need a drama in front of.
Could this be the drama we're looking for? Yes, but it's a sort of drama we have already had in the past, and our experience with it has not been that enthusiastic. So I suggest an alternative. This seems like the best idea. Okay, any other teams?
Hi, I'm from Team Info. I've been here a few times about giving me blog content and everything. And thank you, they start coming, but we still can use them, so please come. Otherwise, do we keep our eyes to the outside? If there's a visitor, they first gonna look at the wiki. If there's this moment content that is incomplete or outdated, they are looking at that stuff. Could everyone please have a look at their own wiki pages and see if they're still up to date? And lastly, we're gonna hand out booklets, and those booklets have the same info. So if you can give me something for in the booklet, then that's gonna be an up-to-date stuff and not outdated. And that would be a pity, because then nobody can find cool stuff that you're doing. So we'll work hard, but we'll need your input. Thank you. Questions? Okay, anybody else?
Thank you. Set it first. Ja, gewoon uit.
Heb je nodig?
Ja, had ik hier. Kan ik
nou. Nou, kunnen wij even te laat. Dus,
Yes.
small school.
Hey, hi, I'm with Team Power, and we have updated our power plan. As you can see, there are some big dots on the screen, right here and here and here. These are the generators we plan to use. There are larger generators here at these points of 200 kVA, because here's a distribution of the power that's already on the train. There are big generators here as well for the track tents. These red lines are 125 amp cables. The other lines here, the small black ones, are the 64 amp cables. The 32 amp distribution is not on this because it will become unreadable. But if you have a need for power somewhere on places not near generators and you need a lot of power, please contact the team. Because we want to know which things are using most power, and we cannot get power everywhere. So please let us know what you need. And it's for not only for Orga, also for villages and people with big projects. We also need to know from Orga, and especially from things like track tents, how much power they need inside those tents, and what they need, how many power cords, and those kind of things. If you have a special equipment like big LED screens, we'd like to know the specifications so we can make sure we have enough power and we have the right cables. And well, that's about it. Things might change a bit, but this is the general idea, and we'll keep you updated if there's more. There's a lot of Schuko, there's a lot of 32 amps power cables, and that's it.
Are there any figures known about the noise levels of the generators?
There are silent ones. I don't know the exact figures, but we can check it. We have details of the generator.
What we saw on the early versions of the drawing was that the radio studio will be on the same line as the food court.
Yeah. I don't know where the radio studio will be. Okay.
Right.
Yeah. Okay.
There is some consensus about the wish to get it on more on the track than on the food court.
Okay.
If that's possible.
It might be possible to get it from the one here and run a cable here, but please put it into a mail to the power team list, and
we will
check it for you. Yeah. Okay. Any more questions? No. Okay. Thank you.
Oh, this. Yeah, thank you. Okay, now if I have my pa here. Yeah. Oh,
okay.
I'm from the team content. Have an update. I guess everybody have seen Hafnarp. This is we schedule talks in a way that everybody that people don't get conflicts. And we have some data about the. Oh, just a sec. Let me get here. We have some data about people that use this. We have about 300 people that use this. 232. And the most liked talks is Shabedge doing the first car hacking, physical penetration testing, detecting a breach from attacker's perspective, and those are the most rated talks. We have about 323 submissions still on FREP. We have done about 180 of them. There is 116 accepted. 21 of them are accepted but not confirmed, because when we accept talks, the person still have to confirm that's going to the talk's going to happen. We still have like 172 submissions that have to be accepted, and that's exactly the reason we are asking the villagers to come forward to host some of the talks and workshops, because we have a lot of submissions. We're not going to be able to host them all. We have 3 lecture tents and 2 workshop tents. So please, villagers, come forward. I have fun. Also, we're going to have lightning talks. Lightning talks are being organized by Nick Farr. Everybody knows him, I guess. Yay! we also have some of those workshop tents we have is going to be hosting Science Trek, that's being organized by Jeroen. Everybody knows him also. And he sent an update about what kind of talks going to be there. And it's a science track. It's going to be for 2 days, from 9 to 3 o'clock. And it's going to be completely arranged by the DIFER platform, with speakers, workshops, etc. The other will be some sessions from the PY lab, the Satori project, and also workshops. The team content has also some additions. We're going to be, like, speaker's desk and the Herald team is going to be sitting under the team content. Well, so far is what I have as an update. I ask again to the villagers, please come forward to host some of the workshops, meetings, and lectures. We're going to be at 11 June. We're going to have a draft of a schedule made public, but it's going to be a draft, so that's about it. Do you have some questions? Any question? You don't have questions? Okay. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Bix from Team Productiehuis. I think it was 2 weeks ago that we decided on which rental company we're going to use for the track tents. We will have stages, there will be audio, there will be lights. We will also have the opportunity to show the slides of the speaker on a big screen. We are working on recording the workshops. That is a little, we need to improvise a little over there because we're reaching our budget already. We are working with C3VOC, who are supplying us with the streaming chain and the cameras and the recording equipment inside the big track tents. We love you guys. and we are already using their streaming network right now to stream this meeting. And this is all for us to, as a team, to get familiar with their setup, so we can build it up ourselves, and then that we will be able to set it up quickly at the event itself. And then during the event, we will need lots of angels, lots and lots and lots of angels. I think we're at 4 in each track tent to get going. So it'd be hundreds of them, hundreds of shifts at least. I'll hope you all volunteer for an hour or so. Shifts will be only an hour for one track, for one talk. You do need a training beforehand, so we do that on day 0 probably. And then let's see if we can make it work. Do you have any questions?
Yes, can the VOC support all digital video formats streamed from a laptop, like HDMI, VJ, that kind of thing?
Yeah, we will support everything. And if you are a speaker, mm-hmm. we will require you to test it with us before you go to the track tent. Because then we can just walk through the tent, bang, connect it, go.
It's not clear to me if we're going to have recordings and other things on the workshop tents.
That's we need to work out how to do that. We don't have the equipment arranged for it, but there are some possibilities that we can make something work, but it requires agreements with a lot of people, and we need to integrate it with the C3 VOC production chain, and those two parts need to combine together, and then we have an opportunity to make the to also record the workshops. So we were working on it. We haven't forgotten, but we are already using most of the equipment in the three track tents. Any more questions? Any more teams that want to present? Yeah, I think we've got the lovely people from the NOC. Okay.
So fast. What? What's? It's also here. Oh yeah, it's doing stuff. Okay. Oh, so small update from NOC. Things are looking good in terms of our preparations and all the equipment we need, and also the uplink towards the field. We are looking for some people to help us out with running the help desk, and also somebody who would like to arrange some stuff for the a public co-location facility, because we had another team that was going to do this, but they then they said they couldn't do it, so right now we don't have anything for a public co-location facility, and we did have this at Ohm and Hard 2009. And we also have a part of the planning on the public map. If this is working. Elger, your stuff is broken. Or it should show a NOC layer here, but I think it's cybered, yeah. Well, anyway, if you go to map.sha2017.org, there's a NOC layer. Where we've drawn in most of the of Datenclos, and we have about 50 of them, and also the switches that will be placed in the Orga supply tents, and so this is where you can see where we are at least planning for network equipment. And if you think there's missing something, please let us know. And if you have any special requirements from the network team, then please write us an email at noc-request@sha2017.org. It's still not working, so... yeah. Any questions? Then, next.
Yes.
Hello, my name is Maurits. I'm the head of the security team for the SHA in this area. Normally, we do this with scouting, because this is a scouting area. We do big and small scouting events, and in the start of the year, we were asked to do this service for this event as well. We are not security guards. We like to connect with the people, try to help them, to serve them where we can, to connect and to try to solve small problems. We like to make big problems small problems, and then it's best to let them disappear. Do you want to say something, Jeroen?
Yeah, I would like to thank Maurits. He was an awesome help with writing of the security plan, the handbook Safety and Security. So thank you for that. Yeah. And my assistant here, Elger, will have safety jackets for everybody working in build up and tear down. We'll have orange reflecting jackets. They will still be printed with some SHA. Yeah, we'll have orange for build up and tear down, and during the event we'll have black for the fire team, green for the first aid, and we had blue for the event management team. Oh, blue was safety and security, and red was for the event team. Yeah, only when we're in function we'll be wearing one of those jackets. Yeah. Anybody else? Not pink. I'm not gonna wear pink. No. Veto. Yeah. Anybody else that wants to? Jort? No, they will still be printed, but time was too short to print them for this meeting. There'll be a nice print on the back, saying whether it's fire, AIBO, or Stuart. Yeah. And the Shruggy, of course. Yes, yeah. Yeah, a fire, yeah. I have a huge problem with that guy. He's been pissing me off all day.
Yeah.
Anybody else that wants to ask a question or say something? Not everybody at the same time. Next team. I guess no more teams.
Well, thanks everybody for sharing their updates. So the rest of today we can do what we want to do, organize SHA even further. I'll be working on some fluorescent tailbacken, these things. There's a lot to do. So. Before we close, there was a request from Hack42. They have two colos, raw containers, whatever. They have like 30 or 40 computers to give away. Core2 Duo, pretty recent stuff. If you want to have that stuff, then you can just get it. So that's. Oh, if your team needs a PC or something, this is the time to get one for free without any hassle. Is there anything else?
Because we needed a lot of lights, we actually tore down an entire building a few kilometers that way. There's quite a lot of spare fluorescent tubes, tailbuizen. If anyone's interested in them, there are various sizes, so basically all standard ones. So if anyone has personal or hackerspace or whatever need for fluorescent tubes, then come to me. We have about 200 spare.
All right, thanks everybody for attending. Thanks for being here. I wish everybody to have a great day today. We're going to do YOLO food again, so about 6 o'clock. If you want to eat Chinese, then we're going to get some Chinese food, and it's about 10 euro per person. I will go drive and get whatever they offer for that amount. So about 6 o'clock, it will be announced here, but some people will also walk around. So, oh, great. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for your time, and have a great day. See you.